Welcome to Bar Talk Radio, where cocktails, content, and the culture collide with a few cocktails. I'm your host, Joy, aka Miss Joy in the City, sitting here with my co-host. I always got to take a breath. With my co-host,
Naziak,
aka
Brooklyn or Bus app.com,
aka
the old Viva La Brooklyn guy. Yo, people, yo, sidebar, before we even go further,
damn,
people still be like,
Viva La Brooklyn. Viva La Brooklyn.
I love it, though.
But you know, it's where you started. You know what I mean? It's a part of your history. It's a part of your story. You know what I mean? Every story's come to an end, but it's still a part of your story.
That's right, right.
And of
that's
course,
right.
And of course, we're also sitting here with Candu, DJ Candu.
Candu.
Wait, hold on. Is Candu's mic on? Oh, y'all dinner. We don't hear you, Candu. Oh, turn your mic on, Candu.
We got to get
you. Hold on.
There you go, because we got the headphones on, so we can hear when it's not together. What's up, Candu? How you doing over there?
Chilling.
On a Wednesday and Tuesday?
You just got the what?
Yeah, I hooked Candu up with a little.
Little song. Oh, so y'all about to be Liberish. I'm low with lip dick. No, okay,
that's right.
No,
that's
we play a whole bunch of shit before, you know, we get
big
started.
Shit.
And we are starting. So as always, we like to get started with the gratitude segment. Want to say thank you so much to everyone who has listened, subscribed, liked, followed, shared, commented, trolled. Did I ever tell you what happened with that? Oh, remind me to tell you what happened.
Somebody trolled you?
When we're talking about the black bottles.
Oh, yeah.
After the show came out, they didn't follow me.
You lying.
I wish I was lying. It's true.
Oh, yeah. Man.
No. It's okay.
Yeah, man. If you don't come back and follow us,
no, it's all right. We know you're still watching.
Bro.
Hey, boo. No.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's a little feelings, man.
Yeah, it's okay. No, that's what's up, though. But anyway.
As Hope say, it's only entertainment.
Yeah, see, and you know we always bring up Hope. See, you know now.
Yeah, definitely.
Even you know now how this goes, okay? So, but just thank you so much to everybody who's listening and checking us out. We do appreciate it.
That's right. Make sure y'all subscribe.
Yep, subscribe.
Follow the Bar Talk Radio page.
Bar Talk Radio, Ms. Joy in the City, Neziak _ NEZIAK. And, of course, DJ Candu, NYC. Don't forget the NYC. So, as always, as my co-host would love to say, what's first in the docket? Before I get to the docket.
Yeah, we're getting to it today.
Yeah, no. Right.
Wait, before we go, one more last promotion.
Yes.
Please make sure y'all visit the website, www.brooklynorbusapp.com.
Once again, say it one more time for the cheap seats.
Brooklynorbusapp.com.
There you go. Make sure we got to get that plug.
Last week was
one of the biggest parties, period. Which was Duce Palooza.
That's right. Duce Palooza.
What's cool about Duce Palooza is it was started in a basement. Like it's something that was an idea that a bunch of guys got together and really started in Palooza in a basement. And to look at where it's actually grown, what it's grown into.
Yeah.
I heard the Barclays was on tilt. Reporting live from Duce Palooza. Neziak.
It's Neziak. I was definitely in that building.
How was it? Talk to us.
This was my first Duce Palooza.
Nice, okay.
I went expecting a party, and one of the guys even put that it would be a party.
Mm-hmm.
But it seemed more like a concert.
Okay.
But then it was the floor area where that was kind of like a party vibe.
Okay.
Mm. But I still got concert vibes from it. But I say this, though.
It's turned into a concert because it was always a party.
I
thought it was at Hammerstein Ballroom.
Right.
It was a big-ass party.
Shouts out to all the people that was at Duce Palooza from the beginning.
When it was Henny Palooza.
I was even embarrassed to tell some people that I was going. And then I was telling some people I'm going. They're like, yeah, that should be off the hook. And I'm like, yo.
Yeah,
man.
Word.
Like,
yo, that shit is your tone.
It's
okay. You was a virgin. Good. You got your cherry popped.
Yeah.
From Duce Palooza.
By the locks. Fabio Ford.
So it's safe to say.
It's safe to say the shit is dope. And let me tell you why I can respect it. Because I don't ever talk about my success to what some deem as success. My idea started definitely both the app and the clothing line both started definitely from the room, the bedroom floor, ground.
The cutting room floor.
So for me to see those guys, to hear a concept start in a basement and get to that point, like just off of that alone, I don't care about if it's a party, if it's a concert. Just off of that alone, hats off to those guys. I don't know y'all, but the Deuce Palooza motherfuckers, whoever.
I know somebody who knows them.
Y'all are. I respect you brothers to the motherfucking T, and that shit don't take nothing away from me. It's dope what they did.
Yeah, absolutely. You know what I'm saying? It was an idea, but let's not forget, like, to take it all the way back to like Amazon. You know what I'm saying? Amazon started. Jeff Bezos started in a garage. You get what I'm saying?
And that's what I'm
trying
to do.
So all ideas start somewhere small. You don't start at the top.
Nah.
It's like planting a seed. Like
that's
legit. It's like I'm memology 101. The day you plant the seed is not the day you have the fruit. So,
that's a fact.
I'm glad that you made it. I wanted to go to Deuce Palooza.
Yeah, yeah. Why you didn't come?
Because I was supposed to go to Mass Appeal's holiday party.
Oh. Big money fucking talk at the table.
She said,
I had real things to go do.
No. Don't do not quote me
Nas.
On that. I didn't say that. I
going
did
to
not
kick it with
say
Nas
that.
In the gang.
I did not say that. I was just saying it was, you know, I had other plans, but I'm glad one third of Bar Talk was there.
That's right. And let's give Can Do hand claps for it being no altercations at Deuce Palooza, because it was a lot of niggas
about.
In the house.
And a lot of Deuce.
Yeah, it was a lot of Deuce and a lot of
niggas.
I was nervous all night.
But for no reason.
For no reason.
Come on, just because black people are all together in a room, it don't mean it's going to be a fight. Shit.
No.
Damn.
Word. I was
shit
like.
Shit get all black, everything.
Like,
it's like,
Brooklyn,
damn.
Deuce, niggas, Barclay. I'm like, oh, buddy.
Security. What? I mean, come on. Right. Metal detectors.
Right.
I don't know.
All
like, come
that.
On. Like,
yo.
Come on.
And then a couple niggas was hitting me still with that attitude of like, how you getting in? How you getting in? Nigga, what the fuck
you mean how I'm getting in? Don't worry about me. Amnesiac. Underscore. Don't forget my underscore, biatch.
Shit, that night I'd have been Viva La Brooklyn.
Whatever get me into the Deuce Palooza. Shit.
Nah, but yeah, shout out to all the people that was there. And it was no altercations, man. That was a blessing too, man.
That's
Brooklyn is really changing, man. Shit is
it's called gentrification. Gentrification like a motherfucker.
Yeah,
but
definitely.
We also had a conversation before we got started. So I'm going to bring it up again for Instagram. So
yeah.
I had posted. you laughing hard.
Yo,
so I had posted. I had posted, babe. Like, and we got like a privacy thing going. It's like, I'm not single, but we don't need to. I'm not
all
out here posting everything.
All we know is that man hand, his beard.
His eyeball, you know. So, but I posted.
Weird stuff.
So
man,
I posted a pic of us. You know, he's my MCE all the time.
Oh, damn,
and I was wearing
shouts out to him.
Shout out to Bay. And
out
I was wearing one of Meziac's charms. So also on my page as well, I also, like anytime I'm wearing jewelry, like I love Stone and Shadow. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
She makes all these jewels that are like very, you know, energetic and all that stuff. So when I post, I tag them.
Right.
So a few weeks ago, it was us and I tagged her. So I tagged Larry in my last one. Larry... And first of all, y'all look childish, okay? I was showing off the jewelry. That's all I was trying to do. I was just trying.
What row is it on your Instagram? What picture?
No, I'm gonna tag you. Fuck you.
Yo, what
happened?
No, this
is my co-host. I would support my co-host in all junctions.
Listen, I just want to say that I didn't have a problem with the picture. Personally, it's everybody else. That had a problem with the picture.
Wait, everybody,
they didn't have a problem. We just guys and we just being immature.
Yo, is that the reason why she don't show his face? Cause it's Larry.
Right.
No, nigga,
like,
that's not even the same beard. What the fuck?
But I say this though.
And everybody who knows, everybody sitting here knows exactly who he is. Like,
right,
come on,
but
jokes.
But do you realize that all the men that are here had the same sentiments though? Like, why are you tagging?
I am tagging the necklace. You know what? I'm untagging. I'm not tagging you again.
Nah,
you
don't gotta tag.
No, it's too late now. Whatever. Fucking
you know
Instagram.
What it is? You know what happened in that incident? Your weirdness trickled over into my life.
You know what? And on that note, first on the fucking docket.
Okay.
Speaking of weirdness, Carol
Joy,
Sanchez.
Joy, thank you. Jokes aside, jokes aside, though, thank you for supporting my brand. I love you.
I always support
your
brand.
That.
I just won't support it when I post pictures with Bay no more. Yeah, that's man. It. That's it. It's over. That's done. That's done.
Leave him out. The other men don't appreciate it.
I'm a flew on my man. I love him. No, I'm sorry.
Fellas,
I'm going
to hold y'all down, fellas, yeah. Respectfully.
Don't worry. I won't tag Nizak anytime I put Bay up. So yes. There's no discrepancies. So, first on the docket, first talking about shit shows.
Yes.
Carol Sanchez. So you,
Carol Sanchez. Oh, you start. You get into the shits early.
Oh, we starting with the shits very early. So earlier in the week, there was an Amber Alert that went out for a young lady that was missing.
Fake ass kidnap.
Okay, can I just break into it? Shit? Apologies. Can you
getting angry thinking about it?
But here's like, okay. No, I can understand why you got angry because before it all came out, everybody. That's the beauty of social media.
Yeah, I never post none of them shits when I see him.
No, sometimes I do.
I posted that one.
I did too. Yo, I posted because I was like, she got snatched in front of her mom. What kind of fuckery?
Here
is
what happened.
This?
I saw that shit on because you know. Motherfuckers don't know I still got a job, but yeah,
it's okay.
I got up early
he got money. He got money. How you
money
think
dance,
it's funded all this shit? This shit costs money.
That's
okay,
right.
But
yeah, I got up at 6 o'clock in the morning. I turned to watch the 6 o'clock news on Fox. Right. Shout out to Fox now.
This nigga here.
And I saw the video, and usually I was just going about my day, like you know, niggas get kidnapped every day, B. But then I go,
chill.
You know what? Larry, you're a father now.
Yes, you are.
I have a son. And if that was him and his mom, how would you feel?
You would be destroyed.
I
would
be
upset.
Devastated.
Right, exactly.
And then I said, you know what, Larry?
We're going
to
post it.
We're going to take it to the gram. Because that's how you know it's real.
Not this comment. It's not real till it's on
you know,
the gram.
Look, Fox 5 News wasn't enough for me.
No, fuck TMZ
fuck
and all
TMZ.
That shit. No.
Fox
it's the
Fox.
Gram. It's Instagram.
It's Instagram.
That's the real.
Get
news.
On the gram before I could even do my due diligence. 1,000 niggas posted it already.
Yeah, no, I see.
Like
I saw a ton
8
of people.
Amber Alerts. Yeah, my phone going off. Yep. The other person's phone going off.
Everybody's phone. I woke up to the Amber Alert and I was like, damn, 16-year-old from the Bronx kidnapped in front of her mother. Here's the first problem that I had. The Amber Alert went out 12 hours after she was missing. That was the first thing that smelled a little fishy to me. Because when a child goes missing, that Amber Alert should go out immediately. Why would you post have the Amber Alert go out when she's been missing for 12 hours? She could be dead by then. Do you
that's
understand
true.
What I'm saying?
That's true.
So that was the first thing that I thought was very weird. Number two, snatched in front of her mother.
Yeah.
I ain't never heard of no shit like that. Yo. I've seen her like walking by herself with a group of girls, but with your moms?
First of all, this is what I want to know. Let's get to the nitty gritty of this shit. When y'all put this plan together, like, who idea was it to say, yo,
a
nigga,
23-year-old boyfriend.
We going to mush your moms in the process.
Like
little
your
girl,
moms,
I will.
You will get your ass.
I'd have been like, little girl, I will mush you before I mush your mother, respectfully.
Yeah, I'm not touching your mother.
Like, why? Like, how
they
you just be okay to, like, shove your mom? Like, yo, there's a special place for you wherever you going. I ain't saying where you going because I ain't
judging. We know where they going.
Girl.
This is hot as this
but
candle.
It's a special place for all of y'all, for sure. Like, y'all really going to get mama love involved? Like, how y'all shove
you gonna
mama
get your
love
mother involved?
On a rainy night, if the floor is wet, The weather is not
you,
the best.
How do you put that plan together and be okay with it? You understand what I'm saying? Different. Like, that's so when it happened.
You know what I blame?
Dick.
No.
That's what this is all about.
No. That goddamn Dick. Popeye's chicken.
You know, all them hormones got your brains going crazy. All your motherfuckers losing it. Everybody who ate a chicken sandwich.
Yo, the Popeye's chickens got y'all fucked up, man.
We don't even know what.
All of you motherfuckers that ate that shit, I've been noticing weird behavior in all you motherfuckers, man.
But did you see the meme 10 years from now, if you ate a Popeye's chicken sandwich, contact us at Jacob Long.
Did y'all all go, Who in here had the fucking Popeye's chicken? Keep it a buck. Who had it? Nobody had it? You have what can't do?
Can't do ate it. Can't do. Oh, we're going to have to watch you. Can't do.
Look. You're going to grow breasts, bro.
I just can't. Honestly, I can't bring myself.
Jokes aside. How was it, though? Was it good?
Yeah, I love it. Can't you say,
Never had the chicken sandwich or something?
I've had Chick-fil-A.
That.
I've had Chick-fil-A. I'm not going to say Chick-fil-A.
So wait, that was your first chicken sandwich, period?
You got to have some
Chicken-fil-A.
The chicken was fat. See what I'm saying? That wasn't no real motherfucking chicken.
That's called hormones. They They let me explain this shit to you. They take a needle and they make the chicken like Superman.
So you know, like in the, like in when they're in the sports, when they're like in the NFL, when they're in the NFL and they take steroids, steroids and they get big. That's the fuck they did.
Can't
to that
do.
Chicken.
Don't eat that shit no more, man.
Don't leave Popeyes alone.
Don't leave that
and
shit alone.
And I also
man.
Hate the fact that they market it strictly in communities of color. Yeah. Think about that. You don't see no Popeyes in the suburbs with lines all the way
your
down.
Your fingers gonna get swollen. You're gonna be able to teach it.
First of all, what's cracking me up is like, he was like, anybody here has a chicken sandwich?
Everybody was quiet. Like, can't do was like, me.
I did it.
Nah,
I did.
But he said it tastes good though, man. So I'm guessing.
It probably tastes amazing. Well, people are fighting. Somebody
fighting
got stabbed over a chicken sandwich. That's a chicken sandwich. Oh,
can't do.
God.
You have to stand in line for that shit?
No. There was no line.
There was no line.
I saw the line though.
Yeah, no, every first, when they first came back out. So we got way off the subject talking about fucking
Popeye's chicken. Popeye's
chicken. No, but I do believe that has something to do with it. Honestly, everybody
just rolled like, yeah, word. That Popeye's
word.
Chicken got exactly.
Yeah,
crazy.
No, you know what? This little bitch had a Popeye's chicken sandwich with her man.
This is my question about that though. What are the repercussions for that type of foolery?
Well, see, we don't. Aside from you just the world looking at you like you're an idiot.
Right.
And number two. Let's also talk about the fact that it's her 23-year-old boyfriend. She's 16, okay? That's called statutory rape, my nigga. She's not even 18.
But that mean he got to be a buffoon, too, to do something like that.
And to be okay with it. First of all, what kind of man are you to be?
That nigga definitely had that Popeye's fucking chicken, bro. That nigga had the
Popeye's,
mild, spicy,
we're
going to
blame all of this. The mild, spicy, and he had the fries to go with it and everything. Like, I'm serious. How are you okay with getting your mom's thrown on the ground?
On a rainy night in the Bronx.
Having an Amber and having an Amber Alert going on.
She
then
had
she
Cardi
when she
B
was returned,
posting that shit too. Everybody, I posted that shit.
I posted it too.
I'm
now
like,
here's
nah,
the thing.
Bring our
when
kids
she
back,
got,
bring our girls back.
No, I'm gonna tell you why this is a terrible thing now. Sex trafficking is at an all-time high.
Yeah, that's why I'm tight
if
that
you
she
picked
did
a
that.
Terrible
time
to do
play
it.
To troll.
Because now when people are gonna be like, oh, it's bullshit. It's not bullshit. But it's really happening.
I'm about to get on my get high shit moment. You know what? Nah, let me not even say all of that because.
What? Oh, you got me all excited. What?
But I got a
theory.
A theory.
What is your theory?
I just find it interesting that, like, everything is just all about trolling in mainstream. Like, I'll give you a scenario.
Like
Kim Kardashian, situation.
Kim Kardashian posing as a black woman?
Kim Kardashian today? Posing as a black woman.
The fuck is
Shorty
that about?
Shorty trolling off of getting kidnapped. 6ix9ine whole situation.
That nigga
Donald Trump situation.
Oh, we gonna get into that too.
Kanye situation, and it's all people. It's all social media / Instagram for clout bullshit.
But
that's
controversy.
What I'm doing wrong.
Oh, you need to be trolling.
Controversial.
Oh, you need to be out here trolling.
Gotta get. The motherfucking trolling gun.
Okay. Oh Jesus Christ! This is what we come to.
I'm gonna tell them on the air. I'm quitting my brand. Everybody gonna get in the comments. Yo, don't do it, bro. We love
well,
you.
Okay, hold on. How trolling works? You can't tell us what you're gonna do. You have to just do it. Okay. See
look, I'm trolling right now.
Yeah. Now you gotta figure out a new plan, Larry.
Yeah,
you gotta figure out a new plan. But
maybe
like,
I take my shirt off tomorrow on the gram.
We'll be looking out for that, Larry. Thank you for that. And my point
tag
is...
Tag you and your boyfriend. Just-
Fuck you, Larry. Fuck you. I'm not tagging you no more. And I'm not even... You know what? I'm wearing this chain right now. Cat this motherfucker back. No, seriously.
Big K shit, sorry. Oh, man, I love this podcast.
Yeah,
this is my favorite podcast. It's hilarious.
I love
like
you too, Larry, but you get
nah,
on my motherfucking nerves.
Nah,
let me, please, let me.
Good,
this is
man.
Why we have the explicit little E next to our podcast,
yeah,
because
man.
Of shit like this.
It's all good.
So, consensus on Carol Sanchez, she need her ass beat.
She need her ass beat, and she definitely need to go fuck back to Honduras after
well, that's,
that dumb
you know
shit.
That, okay, you remember that episode of Martin?
I don't want to go to Arizona, Martin. Yo, I definitely thought about that shit when I seen that episode.
And I know I also immediately thought of Jussie Smollett. Jussie Smollett, in the words of Dave Chappelle. Like, seriously, I really thought about it. And then when I saw the meme come out,
yes.
I was fucking screaming. Because I immediately thought of it. When she was returned right after,
I knew
something was off. I was like, she got returned less than 24 hours later, unharmed. Not sexually assaulted. Not saying that she should be. Please understand. Right. Please understand that that's not what I'm saying.
We're not condoning
that. But nothing is. Nothing happened to her. And she was returned unharmed, unscathed.
Yeah, I heard she like walked to a cop car and was like, hey, it's me, the girl that everyone's looking for the last 13 hours.
Right. And just, you know what it is?
Chilling and shit with
the bros. I'm going to tell you what happened. I'm going to tell you what happened real quick, and then we can get off this. She felt guilty. She felt bad.
I think.
Because, and all this stemmed down to, this is for dick. This was a dick. This was for dick. I'm sorry. I don't care what nobody says. Because when you're 16, you do dumb shit.
I see some girl post on Facebook. If a guy got that kind of genitalia,
keep me away from
she like where he at?
No, where he at? No, keep that shit away from me. I'm good. Obviously, she was, and that's the thing. When you are 16 and you're with someone, especially with a man who's older than her.
But let me ask you a question.
23. Wait.
This what I want to know as a male.
Right.
I notice a lot of times in urban culture, the older guys always like younger girls. Is that really a thing, or is it? Because again,
it's called statutory rape.
Right.
And it's called date women that are your age. They don't really want to date you because they realize that you ain't shit. So nobody your age really want to date you. So you go for younger girls so you can fuck their mind up, because they're going to follow along with it.
But if that's the case, I'm thinking about it now. Yo, it was mad perverted niggas in high school.
Are you kidding me?
It was mad niggas with cars coming to get girls.
Yes, all the time. Drug dealers. Oh, I... Larry,
yo,
we're in the same era. I know.
But I know. That's
and
why
that
I
shit
gotta
was
ask,
wrong
like,
then. That
but
shit
I ain't gonna front.
Then.
When I was at the moment when I was in school, I thought that was, for lack of, I ain't gonna say cool.
Normal.
I thought it was normal.
Right. But here's the thing. Those girls that are getting picked up by those drug dealers, those are the ones, and I'm not trying to play.
Well,
nobody.
All of them drug dealers, let's be fair. Some of them look like regular working class niggas to me.
Well, that's okay. Touche.
Shit.
You know what? Let me not just put the drug dealers.
Look at you, drug dealer shaming. Don't drug dealer
shaming. Sorry,
shame.
Drug shaming. DD shaming. Don't. Drug dealer shaming. My bad. I didn't mean to shame the drug dealers. I mean, you were already an upstanding citizen.
Right.
My bad. Just saying. You know, so, okay.
Shouts out to all the weed slallers.
Look, I'm not mad at drug
Holy
dealers.
Holy
idea. My favorite MC of all time was a drug dealer. I'm not even mad at that.
Right.
So the point is.
Carter.
Right. So the point is. There needs to be a conversation about that, because that's not okay. It's not okay, because what's happening is these young girls' minds are fucked up. They're pregnant at 18.
That's because that's
their
just
whole
started,
lives are changing.
That shit started
and
from high
40,
school, man.
They're 40 with three kids, and then they want to go back to the good guy and be like, "Remember me from high school?" You like,
yeah, they want to come
Cosmic
back.
Trophy, fuck out of here. No, exactly. No.
Yo, you know what's crazy? As I think about it, it was this girl I used to have like a little. Now I ain't gonna say
you
I
had a big
I ain't
ass
even
crush
gonna
on
say
you,
no. I ain't have a crush. I ain't have
a crush.
I ain't have a crush, and I ain't like her. Maybe it was because I felt like she was probably out of my league, but he used to be a grown ass man coming to pick up in a nice BMW. Now that I think about it, that's nasty.
That's disgusting.
Like, that's
kind of a grown ass man.
Yeah.
And you're in what, high school?
Yes.
No.
But
that girl's that girl is not even 18.
She
can't
not, but
even
I ain't
vote.
Go front.
She can't
was,
drink. She
I ain't
can't
gonna
vote.
Lie. She was definitely. I could say it because we was the same age. I ain't do nothing wrong. I wasn't the nigga in the BMW.
You was going to say
she was very developed for her age.
She was very developed for her age. That was the
but
drink
that guy,
milk with the
yo,
mama.
That guy, if you follow me, you are a nasty man.
But no, there was a bunch of nasty men. And that's the problem. There's a bunch of nasty men. I said it.
Yo,
yes.
That's crazy.
There's a bunch of nasty men. And it's like, listen, I got tried when I was younger. And I just felt, I knew it was wrong.
Exactly.
I just felt like I was.
Joe, are you still getting tried to now? Talk about it.
I'm just saying.
I done had this problem all my life.
No. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, I remember there was a rapper that I'm not going to say, but if you follow them, you'll know what they said. He said that the people are mad about the girls that didn't get picked up are the ones that are mad. And saying things like, oh, that's why it's statutory rape, because then nobody wants you back then.
Well,
and I'm not saying who the rapper
lie.
Was.
Yeah,
I know
yeah.
it's like, yeah, I was like,
lie.
Damn, son. So you was picking bitches up. Was
Absolutely.
That what you're trying to say?
Yo, I seen a couple of rappers up at Boys and Girls. I ain't
going
to say no
stop.
Names. You know who you are. You was up at the high.
We just going to let it be. We
couple
let
of
it.
Rappers up at the high.
My point is, really my was. Point is, I don't. First of all, I don't think there's anything wrong with having an age difference. Like, when you get to a certain age, if you want to date someone 10 years older,
yeah,
10 years younger,
yeah,
that's
yeah,
cool.
That's
but if they're still in their teens and you're in your 20s, like, I know someone, and I'm
yeah,
going to
well,
I'm gonna pull
case,
up a story that I
that
know
case,
in my own
shouts
life.
Shouts out to some of these grown-ass women that's still acting like goddamn teens.
Okay, we'll see. What? Whoa,
yeah.
That was... You all right over here, Larry? Yeah. Whoa. You
get, Took it a little personal.
Yeah, I see. I said, take it. Listen, Monica, don't take it personal. Okay, no, seriously. There's a problem with older men dating younger women that are not of age. If right. If she is 20 and she wants to date a 40-year-old, you guys, it's weird to me because you're not in the same age range and you can't, don't really have anything to connect on, if in my opinion. But that's your business. I'm not here to judge you.
Let's flip the script. Like, let's Mrs. Robinson, what about older women
dating younger men? Same thing. That's
Kitty. Pardon me one second, Joy. Kitty boss.
Quick, Kitty's on there.
You hardly see me because, like Lil Wayne said, no, Drake said, hardly ever some because I live in my workplace.
This nigga stopped the recording.
Yo, and the Christmas party is tonight. Ah. Sidebar. Let's go.
Welcome back to Bar Talk Radio. Yes.
And make sure you subscribe to Bar Talk too because you get me in trouble by my co-host. Yeah, make sure you subscribe.
Hi, Kitty. Hey, girl.
Hey, girl. Subscribe to the podcast, girl. Bar Talk Radio on the little purple icon in your phone. And anybody else listening to this episode, please make sure y'all take this time to subscribe. I have to get back on Joy Goodside. So subscribe to the podcast.
Subscribe and follow us. Thanks for that. That was a great commercial. Now back to our regularly scheduled program.
Let's get it going.
Needless to say, this actually jumped off into something completely different from Carol Sanchez playing herself to older men.
So you older nasty men.
And women. Women too, because
women,
not fair. It's not fair to just be like, oh, yachting is in there. No, women as well.
These older women, sometimes they definitely be looking at me with the wacky eyes. I'd be like,
not
yo,
the wacky eyes.
The
goodbye,
wacky eyes.
Larry, you got something to offer, and all they really want, all they really want is, well, anyway. Anyway, so the point is hard dick and bubble gum. That's all you got.
And
anyway,
I'm always out of bubble gum.
And on that note, we are going to just go ahead and we can agree to disagree that there's some fuck shit.
Yeah.
Speaking of more fuck shit.
Let's get to it. Keep the fuck shit rolling on it.
Well, it's all about fuck shit today. Today's episode is going to be called the fuck shit. I don't know if we can.
Shit.
Well, I have to do
Bob.
It. I have to.
Bobby. Sorry.
Larry, welcome to
it. I feel like I'm still at Deuce Palooza. God damn.
This nigga's still having a good time.
I was paranoid as shit in there. Oh, my God. Lights is low, bunch of niggas drinking Douce.
Smoking. You knew that was
clicks
happening.
Of niggas. I was like, oh, man.
I'm going to just stay right here. Just I did.
Got it right. This is kind of like a gangster party.
Yeah, but a gangster party. So, our orange, well, not my president. Never my president. So, apparently, he's on the road to being impeached. So, this is what I love about social media. Everybody's running around. Oh, he's impeached. She's impeached.
Yeah,
I'm gonna need you to do a little bit of research. Just
y'all that posted that he got impeached. No. Y'all are a bunch of goofs.
Right.
Like,
so what happens is when the last president to actually be impeached was Clinton, and everybody's like, oh, he got impeached because of a blowjob. No, he did not get impeached because of a blowjob. He got impeached because of perjury and obstruction of justice. That's those were fact. The actual charges that were brought about him, and he lied. That's what perjury is. He lied on the stand to a grand jury. That's same thing like Lil Kim. That's what happened. She for perjury, grand jury, right? You know, because she's a G. But the point is, I'm just saying.
Shout out to Brooklyn.
Brooklyn. So that's what happened with Bill Clinton. So our actual president, I'm saying this in air quotes,
right.
He's not actually impeached yet. He's on the road.
No.
The charges have been brought against him. They actually have to vote on it. Exactly. So everybody, this is what I love and hate about social media. Kind of like news travels very fast.
Word, a couple of niggas, people be saying people died on social media. Niggas be dead alive from their account.
Wait, I saw that a few times. I forgot who that last person was that was like, oh, he dead. And he was like, think Sinbad.
Yeah, he was like, yo.
He was like, yo, that's it. You just gonna kill me. Oh, fuck y'all. Like, no. Like, yeah, and that's the thing. See, social media is great to get the information out there. But I implore you, please, before you just start posting away, when you see something on social media,
do your research.
Like, go and do it because everybody's like, oh, Trump is impeached. I ain't seen so many political people on social media in a minute. Like, people will jump on the bandwagon
hard. I'm about to stir the pot. This is the thing I got to. Let me just be on politics. This is shit that be getting me mad, right? When somebody say they don't vote, motherfuckers be like, you can't have opinion. I got something to say to you motherfuckers now that I got a platform about that shit. That's the most stupidest shit.
You don't have an opinion, Larry.
I don't care what they say about not having an opinion. Those be the same motherfuckers that they couldn't tell you who their local fucking representative is. Like, how dare you argue with me about a world global problem and you can't, you don't even know who's the person in charge for your little brother's school lunch.
Get I'm going to tell you why.
Here.
Because it looks so cool on social media to have the sticker that I voted. Because
I'm grown now. I want to argue with you niggas about that, you don't vote so you can't have an opinion. Nigga, you don't even know who your local senator is, bro.
You know what? I'm not even going to argue with you. Here's the thing. I'm not going to argue with you on that, Larry, because that is a point. I do believe that you should exercise your right to vote.
Make this crystal clear. I'm not saying that. I'm not telling nobody not to vote. I'm not saying that. This is just where people make the comment and say, if you don't vote, you don't have an opinion. You can't have an opinion.
Well, the reason
motherfuckers
why, the reason
don't
why,
brush
I'm
their teeth
you,
and still talk to motherfuckers every morning.
Oh, God, please don't ever do that. The point is,
but does not happen.
Don't ever do that. Come that's on. Woo, Jesus Christ.
Yo, you can't have an opinion. You can't vote. Nigga, what's your local senator name? Huh? When the last time you went to a pep rally on your block? When the last time you signed a petition for your motherfucking block party? Okay. Niggas just block partying.
Okay. Welcome to the block party. No, I understand where you're coming from with that. But you got to understand the reason why people get upset with people, especially people of color who do not vote. People have died for the right to vote. And that's why it's so important to exercise that
right. That's right. Exercise the right to vote, but also understand what your little brother is eating at school and what's going on in them after school programs.
Right, no, 100%.
Because niggas don't never want to debate that.
The point is, that everyone wants to look cool for social media.
Yeah,
Freudian slip.
Stuck with
Donald Trump has been impeached. No, he has not. There is a process for it. And it drives me nuts when people go running
and don't research it. These the same buffoons that's telling you that if you don't vote, you don't have an opinion. So
Larry, somebody said that to you, you got so mad. Larry's mad.
What do I say to you numbnuts that's posting that he's impeached and he's not impeached? But you
he's
the same
on the,
people
he's on
telling
the road. He's
me
on the road.
That if I don't vote, I can't have an opinion.
Larry, but if you don't vote, you can't have an opinion.
I don't have an opinion. I just want niggas to know what their little brother's eating for lunch.
You hold it steadfast to that. Yeah, my thing is, I implore everyone, please. Please vote. One, that's number one. Please vote.
Number two,
whenever you see something on social media, before you run with it, do your research. It is. Don't take it for surface value. For face value. Thank you. Do not take it for face value. Because a lot of this stuff.
Even when you tag me with the boot.
And on that note, I think we're going to take a quick break. Yo, you get on my nerves, yo.
Candle.
I ain't tagging you with shit. Watch on radio.
Probably heard I was broke from a broke nigga. Probably heard I'm a hoe from a hoe. I don't know what you know, I ain't running from nothing. Let's go. These bitches be waiting in line at the shows. I don't want fuck with her, let my bro hit her. Nope. I'm the first one to come out of Charlotte. Okay. Nigga know I put on for that faux nigga. About to buy a new Lambo, let's go nigga. From tired of selling them zips, get a boat nigga. Me and Di used to post at the store. No cap. Gucci man and no six. With my dope nigga. Yeah. I told her I keep her invoices. Uh-huh. Why you rich and you keep wearing forces? Yeah. These niggas, they lactose intolerant. How about you? Bitch, I'm married to cheese, no divorce. Bitch, you can't get a ring. If you want, I pull up with a bitch that's so thick, think I'm Norbit. Slamming a hoe like I'm O'Neal. She want money for pussy, bitch, no deal. No, you can bet if I fuck, it's a freebie. Free. Bitches pay VIP just to see me. Uh-huh. I'm a sharky and shrimp, nigga, peewee. Shrimp. Fuck a rap, I spit on the CD. Bitch ass nigga. Probably heard I was broke from a broke nigga. Probably heard I'm a hoe from a hoe. I don't know what you know, I ain't running from no nigga. Let's go. These bitches be waiting in line at the shows. I don't want fuck with her, let my bro hit her. No, I'm the first one to come out of Charlotte. Okay. Nigga know I put on for that faux nigga.
Four.
Probably heard I was broke from a broke nigga. Probably heard I'm a hoe from a hoe. I don't know what you know, I ain't running from no nigga.
Let's go.
These bitches be waiting in line at the shows. I don't want fuck with her, let my bro hit her. Bitch. I'm the first one to come out of Charlotte.
Okay.
Nigga know I put on for that faux nigga.
Let's go.
I'm still in the city, bitch, no doubt.
Yeah.
Gotta give me 6 figures to go
yes,
out.
Sir.
I count up 50K for a walkthrough.
Count up.
You drop me in my show, we gon' show out.
Bitch.
I just left the club with your hoe.
Fucked her right on the floor.
Say I fucked up a blowout.
My bad.
My bad, boo. I thought that was weed.
Orange juice.
The first nigga try me, I squeeze.
Let's go.
Before I fucked up, fucked a few of her friends. Can you tell her stop calling me, please? Bitches know I'm a dog off the leash. A big dog, niggas call me OG.
OG.
Cross that line with us, she can't come back and say sorry. My city, they call it a plea. Let these rap niggas lie like a sweet. I'm from Charlotte, you die when it's beef. Nigga. Probably heard I was broke from a broke nigga. Probably heard I'm a hoe from a hoe. I don't know what you know, I ain't running from no. These bitches be waiting in line at the show. I don't want fuck with her, let my bro hit no. I'm the first one to come out of Charlotte. Okay, they know I put on for that four nigga. Probably heard I was broke from a broke nigga. Probably heard I'm a hoe from a hoe. I don't know what you know, I ain't running from no. Let's go. These bitches be waiting in line at the shows. I don't want fuck with her, let my bro hit me. I'm the first one to come out of Charlotte. Okay, they know I put on for that four nigga. Let's go. Hey, snap.
Only thing I'll we put like my foot on the gas.
Take off, I can not let these boys pass me. Make a move and the scene will get nasty. He get jammed since he wanna be flashy. Keep a shooter on deck till he blast me. So you already know he gon' blast me. Mario bro, smashing. He get hit with that Glock if he backing. I hit that shit, hold the neck. A chest shot to break out his back. Smoking dope in the back of the back. Got a Glock with a tech round the neck. There's no warnings, he talk, he get stretched. I don't like when they talk out their neck. If we coming correct. No, if we coming with straps. Facts, bro throwing bullets, he getting you picked off. Receipt a pack like we just got the kickoff. Shout out to Yola, no Clifford, that's big dog. Won't fuck your bitch cause she don't get my dick hard. Quick to spin right down your block. No man to throw couple shots. Hit him up, ain't talking to pop. Lift him up, yes you can get rocked. I do my dance on that hoe. Throwing ones while she dance on the pole. I hit that shit on the low. Psych, I hit that shit with my bro. Kick her out, that bitch gotta go. She gon' make me late for my show. And she loving the way that I flow. I'm hot, bitch dropping roll. Get with me. I'm catching vibes from silly. They know I ride with killers. And them killers know why I get busy. Facts, it get wicked. And they know I stay on my pivot. Make a move and that's where you gon' miss it. Where he at? He swim with the fishes.
I said I'm moving like a soldier move. My bitch is unapproachable. When I shoot my Uzi, man, I do that little shoulder move.
Only thing we like raw is hip hop.
Make a sound, make a sound. I said I'm moving like a soldier move. My bitch is unapproachable. When I shoot my Uzi, man, I do that little shoulder move. Yo, bitch ain't gon' fuck with you. She stopped because I told her to. Niggas look like income tax. Can't wait to get a hold of you. Yellow dress, who is you? Holla back. Brought her here, Uber black. Send her back, Uber pool. She might get out of garden. Pussy taste like Jamba Juice. Baby mama on my body, even more than Mama Seuss. Look, blessed and anointed. Facts. Nigga, how you want it? Facts. Don't make me call up ghosts. Somebody getting haunted. Hello? Her, she fuck some other nigga. She just end up disappointed. Got these pussies pocket watching like our bank account is joining. Look, for a nigga popped, I was sleeping on a cot. Look, now I got it lit. 100 watts in the spot. Look. Know that I'm that nigga, but I be acting like I'm not. I got tats all on my belly, I be feeling like I'm.
I know who the fuck I am.
I be flexing like a wrestler, yeah. Charged up like a Tesla, yeah. Switching out my hoes, I dump Siri for Alexa. Look, my next baby mama look like Evelyn Lozada, nigga. I'm the perfect age to get the daughter and the mama, nigga. Look, niggas talking crazy when I'm not around. Random tame niggas, you be acting wild. Ooh. Heard I wanna clip it shorty, other way around. Ooh. 5 a.m. at La Capella, man, I'm about to take it down. Make a sound, ooh, ooh, make a sound, ayy, ooh, make a sound. I'm about to take it down. Play time with baby Jordan, only time we play around. 5 a.m. at La Capella, man, I'm about to take this.
How sick? I'm feeling richer than ever.
I am.
Old friends like Favi, we should be sticking together.
Ayy.
If I change, then I did for the better. Made it up a storm. I said a flight. No, I'm not missing the weather. No issues, my only problems. All this money's gonna fit in this leather. I'm gonna miss him, whatever. She wanna stay in it, she better get it together. Said A three times and made it the littiest letter.
Hey, hey, hey.
When they get it, I'm better. Can't walk in my shoes. And you can't fit in this sweater.
Only thing we like raw never, is hip hop.
Smart, clever, revenge, vendetta. We see him, we get him. I'm with a wedding, she getting wetter and wetter. I gotta turn up, it's part of my daily endeavors. Watch you talking to, write your remarks, I'm remarkable. Turn around, doggy style, I'm dogging you. Ay, ay, ay. There's money involved, she a rider and she come with a car. There's money involved, she a rider and she come with a car. I'm feeling richer than ever.
I am.
Old friends like Favi, we should be sticking together.
Ay.
If I change, then I did for the better. Made it out the storm,
I
said a flight, no, I'm not missing the weather. No issues, my only problem is how this money's gonna fit in this leather. I'm gonna miss him, whatever. She wanna stay in it, she better get it together. Said A three times and made it the littiest letter.
Hey, hey, hey.
But when they get it, I'm better. You can't walk in my shoes, and you can't fit in this sweater. Ay, I'm feeling richer than ever. Rolls Royce, she got the orange leather. All my money gotta stick together. Now my bitch, she like a Cinderella. She brought a bitch, now it's a get together. My niggas rich, go get your shit together. Cut the rape, come with a new umbrella. He a lane, tell her do better. I took a flight. Neck good, but she can't stay the night. Five. I got the money, I'm rich, they all on my body. Hit the bitch, left her right in the lobby. Cut the porch, cause I deal with the Audi. Rest, sloppy. Bank account. Pop.
I'm feeling richer than ever. Old friends like Foggy, we just sticking together. If I change, then I differ better. Made it out the storm. I said a flight. No, I'm not missing the weather. No issues. My only problem is how this money's gonna fit in this leather. I'm gonna miss him, whatever. She wanna stay in it. She better get it together. Said 8-3 times and made it the Lydia's letter. Hey, hey, hey. When they get it, I'm better. Can't walk in my shoes. And you can't fit in this sweater. Hey, never. Too smart, clever. Revenge, vendetta. We see him, we get him. I'm with a wedding, she getting wetter and wetter.
Only thing we like raw is hip hop.
Been all
looking
at
her.
I'm gonna if you want your purse. Oh baby, you be lining your verses. I be here and say you buying them purses. I can't even lie, you ain't my type. You ain't even know that's fine in person. I can guarantee you if you my kind, she got every bag you can imagine. Big house, I can really be bragging. 100,000 in my mouth like what's happening. Not the big cheap tea, that's embarrassing. He ain't me, you can keep the comparison. My bitch probably one of the baddest. Good girl, turning into a sad. This bitch got a problem in traffic. We can't do it, imagine G-Wagon. Low key, I've been keeping it classic. Could be really out here doing them nasty. Niggas couldn't even see me in last year. Just started and them niggas in last year. I ain't even tried to and I passed them. Giving looks, I contribute to fashion. Drop a song, I be giving them caps. Stand alone, not your regular rapper. Brand new car is noisy. Come to when it's roaring. You ain't gotta worry. Don't care about your boyfriend. See me and get nervous. I damn near did it perfect. Work hard and determined. It's safe to say I earned it. Yeah. None of you guys can flash me. Whoa. Matter of fact, none of you guys can hush me. Whoa. Post my trip up daily just so they can see. Whoa. Turn me up some more so my haters can hear. Whoa. I put it dope in the back of the car and I tell her to go. She hit where she land, she bring the band, she back on the road. She know how I get when I get in that mode. Ain't fucking with bitches, ain't buying no clothes. Only do shows and make me some songs. Make sure the other shit come and get sold. We fuck with these scribbles cause we play with poles. We play with our money and not what I know. I used to go to the west to get lost. I just came back from the west with a trophy. I'm on some motion. She said she missed it and sending emojis. No time to kick it on my west in motion. Can't say I miss you, I don't got emotions. I'm on that bitch.
In the spot. Yeah. Perfect. What about?
Only thing we like raw is hip hop.
Big drip, big drip. I'm in love with a lit bitch. Ayy, crip shit. Ay. She wanna suck on the lit dick.
Ayy, ayy, ayy.
Couple bitches I get lit with. Couple bitches I get lit with. I been spent. I give a fuck who you been with.
Ayy, ayy, ayy.
Bow. They loving the style.
They loving the style.
Send me the Addy, I'm hunting them down. Send me the Addy, I'm hunting them down. Bow, bow, bow. Bitch, I'm on demon time. Straightforward, I don't need a line.
I don't.
I just wanna watch it the free time.
I did.
I bought it with me, I ain't leaving mine.
Bow, bow.
I bought it with me, I ain't leaving mine. Shoot it with me. I give a fuck if you coolin' with me. You say you ain't GDK.
What?
What the fuck is you doing with me?
Hold on. With me.
Yeezys. I need the money and beanie.
Hey.
Bitch, tell me that she need me. Probably hey. I don't like the way you treat me.
Hey, hey, hey.
Biggies. I'm giving number figures.
Figures.
The man person, now you believe me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Free souls are here, demon.
Ay.
Geeked up, geeky.
Ay.
We winning, we on defense.
Ay.
She let me fuck on the weekend. Shorty a baddie.
Baddie.
She try to add me.
You cannot add me.
She cannot hide me.
No.
Little mommy, I'm married.
Mommy, I'm married.
If you keep it secret, yeah. We can all be happy.
What?
We can pose a picture. But you better not tag me.
You better not tag me.
Look,
bitch.
Winning. Looking for him, spinning.
Ay.
Demons with me, sinning.
Ay.
Bust it up, walk away grinning.
Crowd bow.
Winning, looking for him, spinning.
Spinning.
Demons with me, sinning.
Sinning.
Bust it up, walk away grinning.
Bow, 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 bow.
Big drip,
big drip.
I fell in love with a lit bitch.
Ay.
Crip shit.
Ay.
She wanna suck on the lit dick.
Ay, ay, ay.
Couple bitches I get lit with. Couple bitches I get lit with. I been spent. I give a fuck who you been with.
Ay, ay, ay.
Bow. They loving the style.
They loving the style.
Send me the Addy, I'm hunting down. Send me the Addy, I'm hunting down. Bow. Bow.
only thing we like raw is hip hop.
DJ. Swear to God, she a bad bitch. Savage. Swear to God, she a savage. Bust it down, carriage, swipey baby, I'm in plastic. Speeding, traffic, Uber, past it. Babbage, swear to God, she a babbage. Savage, swear to God, she a savage. Bust it down, carriage, swipey baby, I'm.
And we are back. Turn the mic back. Welcome back to Bar Talk Radio, where cocktails, content, the culture, and someday I'm going to get this fucking shit right, but welcome back to Bar Talk Radio. We just had a break. We have DJ Candu here. We have the Bar Talk.
Candu!
We have the Bar Talk playback. Tell us exactly what you played on the break, Candu.
I just played a couple songs just released about 2019. Mm-hmm, I'm working on the new mixtape, so.
The 2020 mixtape.
Mixtape is coming now, and then checking the new songs.
Can't do. No. And tell them who you got him sponsored. Tell them who you got the last minute sponsor. Can't do.
Brooklyn or Boston.
Hey.
That's kind of big drip, you know.
That's kind of big drip.
Can't do.
That was a plug. That was a flex.
That's right, hey. Can't do. That should go up on the website and all that. Can't do. We rocking.
Well, welcome back. And we definitely, of course, you know, when that comes out, we're going to be posting that everywhere. So keep us posted, Can't Do for 2020. So we're back. We had a whole political debate on the break. I mean, we had the conversation about Trump and impeachment. Oh, man,
yeah, you know when it get political.
Politics.
I ain't going to lie. It got intense. You know why, though? I blame myself for starting that, though.
Yeah, you did. Larry's a shit starting fucking Gemini.
That's why I don't do it, man.
Gemini. He's a shit starting Gemini.
That should get the ball rolling fast,
you know,
boy.
It was a very, very heated debate. It got on Google.
The soundboard guy said, everybody shut the fuck up right now. I was like, oh,
get down and lay down. Here's the facts.
Said, my little brother going to get that free lunch, you
can't stand you.
Nah, but so I love it though. It's good energy, man. And I'm glad we could enlighten each other. It's beautiful.
Absolutely.
Man.
You never want to be the smartest person in the room. If you are, you are in the very
wrong room.
That's such a statement. We'll talk later about, you know, 2020 and moving forward and what's going on with that. But while we're leaving it in 2019, ASAP Rocky has had one hell of a year. He got locked up in Sweden. Everybody, you know, I was very split on that.
No. Let's take it back to one of the old episodes.
Yes. Okay. So when we were talking,
first off, when the episode where I said,
that's the rewind.
ASAP Rocky, when he said, "If I was doing dishes,
I would still be fucking bitches."
Yeah.
Right. He loves bad
at
bitches.
At that point,
he loves bad bitches. That's yeah,
like
a problem.
I love bad bitches. Was a problem. That's
you know. He know. He likes the like, fuck. Oh, he got a fucking problem.
But
right.
Then when I heard the other shit with him and Ferg, when he said that line about if I was doing dishes,
I would still be fucking bitches. I believe it.
This thing got a problem.
I believe it. But here's the thing. I also had a problem with saying. Remember, we went back and forth about it. How he was like, he don't care about what's happening in Ferguson because he's in Beverly Hills fucking bitches. So you know that was a problem for a lot of black people. Like it was very split.
Yeah,
I understand.
Black women culture, they'll cancel you fast.
Cancel culture came his way.
See how I toned down on the B word.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Like, now we're working on females. We're getting there, Larry. One step at a time.
I'm going to change soon, women. Women's.
Change going to come. Yes, it is. We're working on it. But he basically was like, you know, nah, he don't understand what's going on in Ferguson.
Right.
He doesn't connect to that. Right. And a lot of people had a problem with it. And
he wasn't tapped in.
Right, exactly. And then of course what happened in Sweden, everybody was like, well, we ain't tapped in either, fam. Like it's just what happens. Like, you know, cancel culture
came
your way.
We're gonna tap out on this one.
We're gonna tap out. Good luck, my man. Good luck with that. But then he got released. I never want to see a black man behind bars, especially not abroad. Right. You know, we are just, even though we don't have the same views, I never want to see
that. Yeah, not even ASAP Rocky bitch ass.
You know, right. Exactly. So,
and
then
I'm only
went,
saying that because, you know,
what?
just doing a bunch of wild shit.
Yeah, that's right. Larry's in his trolling shit.
Nah,
but wait, before we go into that.
You know what it is with ASAP Rocky? Like, they stay posting pictures. And I don't be knowing if it's real or not.
What is your, hold on.
Well, my
microphone pause. Is your mic on?
No, it's on.
Hello? Oh, yeah. So the problem that I had with ASAP, like I said, I just did not like the fact that what happened with him when he said he just wasn't connected to black people. Oh, wait, I think, and we are good.
Yes.
Okay, there we go. And we're on.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, see, that's what, that was the Lord cutting your mic off, Larry.
I know, right?
Lord cut your mic off.
Right, right. I'm good now? Okay. Yeah, that's good. That started that shit.
He started trolling his mic. Piece fell out. Legit, no lie. He started trolling in a piece of the mic that lets him talk.
How was that beast shutting me up?
Yeah, they're like, Larry, keep your ass over there. Don't do it, bro. Cancel culture coming your way.
Right.
But no, with ASAP, then he also went on Angie Martinez and he was like, you know, he has a sex problem and he was a sex addict.
That's what I forgot.
That's what we were jumping into, right?
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. With ASAP Rocky, the only reason why I made that last comment, because it'd be weird. Like, they be posting some wild pictures of him. Yeah. But I don't be knowing if it's real pictures or
if it's trolling.
Or if it's fake, they be drawing pictures like him with like Calvin Klein drawers pulled up and like he's just.
Well, no,
like,
he wasn't a Calvin Klein ad. That was true. That was real. Like, that was real. I don't. So needless to say, I found out a few days ago why ASAP was trolling again. I mean, sorry, not trolling. My bad. Trending. Whoops, wrong T word. And I went and looked, and apparently there's a sex tape that leaked. So
you watched it?
I went right on over to Pornhub. I'm not ashamed. I went over to Pornhub. I typed in ASAP Rocky. A lot of questionable shit came up. I wasn't really ready to see. But I wasn't. And whoa, nah. Learned what the and then you know the in porn there's
right.
Basically right. In real life. I was like, oh shit. So then I, you know, there's also acronyms for things. I was like, what is a POG? That's fat ass white girl. I learned that too.
Right.
I was in Pornhub. I was like, this is interesting. This was all research.
Man, Joy, so you get your porn. Joy, get your Pornhub cut, Joy, a check.
No, I'm just keeping. Well, I didn't know where else to find it. If you go to Google, it's not gonna come up. So I was like, the only place to find a sex tape.
Right.
Is a porn site. Come on, we adults. Well, here.
I'm sure the ladies want to know. So, how was the sex tape? I'm sure you women love ASAP Rocky. So,
well, one, shout out to ASAP Rocky for using protection. He was wearing a condom. Two, it was a white girl with a big old booty.
Mm-hmm.
Just, you know, and it looked like back shots. It was. That's all I got for you.
You don't sound too. You don't sound like. Well, just from the way. First of all. I could tell by the way you spoke about it that that's not the category where you would like normally go on this. I could tell.
I'm
like,
no, we're not having this conversation. Yeah, that's what this ain't about. Right, right.
Like, I was trying to get like
talking about. No, you're right, getting in my business.
Get a,
no.
I was trying to get like a raw emotion out of you.
Yeah, bro. No, Larry, like, you will not be asking my history.
It was just like back shots, you know, regular white girl, like Joy. Clearly, this is not a category that you do.
That I do. Why? What you heard? No, I'm joking.
Big education.
Bobby. No, I went and looked at it. Look, come on, back in the day when R. Kelly had his tape, everybody went and fucking wanted to watch it. Who didn't see the R. Kelly sex tape?
The golden. I didn't see it.
You didn't see the R. Kelly sex tape?
I don't think I saw any sex tapes.
Yeah, you don't watch porn?
No, I don't watch porn, no. I don't watch porn. Why the room got so quiet? Damn, what? Fuck. I don't watch porn.
Wait.
Everybody looked at me Larry.
Look, next on the docket, Larry doesn't watch porn. Wait a second, stop the fucking.
I don't watch porn.
But okay, ASAP, the sex tape was okay. Larry, back to you.
Somebody is in my live dying laughing.
Yo, I don't watch porn.
Quiet.
You can hear you can hear a mouse pissing on cotton in here after he said that shit. Like, I don't watch porn. I'm sending you a link. From the show, I'm sending you a link. Matter of fact, where's my phone? I'm sending Larry a link right fucking now. So wait, no, you don't watch porn at all?
Nah, no porn at all, man. I've never seen a sex tape.
I'm sending you all kinds of shit. You know what? No, let me not do that.
Joe,
bad enough I tagged you. Let me not send you sex links too. This is gonna get real awkward. You know what? Scrat, can we edit that? Can we remove this whole thing from it? But okay, sorry. We'll get back to ASAP. Yeah, we'll talk offline about
as you
Larry's
said, this is
habit.
Not about you asked me if I saw it. I said no.
So nobody else in the room? So I'm just mad awkward. I'm the only one in the room that saw the
ASAP? Anybody else in the room watch porn?
No, that's not the question.
Oh, sorry.
Fellas, stay quiet. We're not going to get your business right now. But no, I was saying, is there anybody else in the room who saw the ASAP sex tape, allegedly? Okay, one shaking their head no. Okay, two shaking their head no. Okay, nobody so does. I'm the only weirdo in the room.
No, you're not. No. Tell me, you're not. We the only female. Like
I'm the only woman.
Sorry. Yeah. Oh man, we gotta work on that. Yeah, you're the only
woman
in the room that wanted to see.
And I'm the only woman. I'm the only woman in the room. And I'm the only person that watched the porn. Okay, whatever. Yeah. It was him.
Says a lot about you if you ain't feeling us.
All I'm saying this was research for the show.
I went
to see if it was really him. And the tattoos gave it away.
I don't even want to see an algorithm with the Pornhub shit. Like, I'm scared now.
Why?
Like,
when did this become my algorithm for Pornhub? Like, come on, bro.
I looked up under ASAP Rocky.
That's how I searched it. How else was I going to search him? Like,
under Rocky? No, I'm joking.
My nigga, there's a whole bunch of other shit you don't want to see coming up under that either. No, thank you. My point is, ASAP Rocky has had one hell of a year, and I do believe that is him. But sex tapes have made people famous.
Yeah, sex tapes happen every day, B. That shit ain't
Well, here's the thing. Unless they're leaked, they don't become sex tapes. Like, there are people who sell it. Like,
ASAP Rocky probably got an album coming out top of the year. Like, let's cut the bullshit out. ASAP probably got an album coming out.
There's no cease and desist. Nobody's taking it off the site.
Yeah, he condoned that shit. They had to hit him up, especially like right now with everything that's going on around him. He lawyered up left, right, and center.
But here's the thing: he's not the first person to have a sex tape. Kim Kardashian had a sex tape. Paris Hilton had a sex tape. Love and Hip Hop Mimi had a sex tape. Ray J and Kim Kardashian, that's the same. Sex tape. Stevie J had a sex tape. Wait, Stevie J had a sex tape?
They were a little. That's how you start rumors.
Look, where's my porn? Oh, no,
with Eve, yes. With Eve.
Oh, back in the day. Yeah. Johnny Blaze. Oh, Johnny
Real fast. Quick shout out. Yo, we ain't shout out our photographer real fast. What we going to promote?
He out here taking.
Matter of fact, come get on the microphone. Just say your shit one time.
So, real quick.
What you doing, everybody? Just follow me, endless_3x photography.
All right, here we go.
Endless3x photography.
We got I can't. I'm excited to see these shots. Promo coming your way.
And ladies, don't worry, he watches porn.
Fucking hate this one. Oh my god. Yeah. So yeah, no, I just thought it was very interesting, and apparently it's even more interesting because I'm the only one who went to go watch it. So next on the docket, I just want to say thank you to everybody who's sitting in this room right now.
It's Our a lot of radio good vibes. Is, it's a lot
but
of good
we're back.
Vibes
like
room.
We're back. We took a year long hiatus. Mm-hmm. And you know, it was questionable. It was like, oh, y'all gonna come back? What's going on? It's like I always knew we would come back. I just
stronger than ever.
We on iTunes and shit. No, but I just want to say thank you to everybody in the room. S.STREET Media. First of all, huge shout out to S.STREET Media, which is our brand new home. So we just want to say thank you for getting us the edited version that we get
that's
to
right.
iTunes.
I like it, her. Yes, you can also catch the app on Brooklyn.
Catch the podcast on
BrooklynOrBustApp.com.
Yeah, let's not forget that. Of course, Candu. Candu, let me tell you something about Candu. Candu's been rocking with Bar Talk Radio since the very first show, April 4th, 2015.
Shout out to Candu.
So Candu is one
Give
of the original.
Give me some hand clap, Candu.
Word. With some hand claps for Candu. There we go.
Mr. Many
ladies.
Candu, listen. All the ladies, man. Kendu, I got an idea that I just had in mind. I think for merch, I think that'd be a good t-shirt.
Many ladies.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, you better copyright that because now it's out in the ether now. You come to his party. No, we're going to get you
Kendu,
that shirt
you get
made.
The shirts made and
yeah,
you get that
you.
Shit
that's
going.
Kendu's.
Many ladies. Yeah.
Kendu's merch. But no, but back to just want to give a shout out to, of course, Star. Get a shout out to
Chastity.
Always.
J Fats.
DJ Silk, who was a part of it and then wasn't.
DJ Silk,
just everybody who's rocked with us, everybody we interviewed. Like if you go to YouTube, you can actually see the work that we actually put in. This is the podcast. This is episode 8 of the actual Bar Talk podcast. But we've been rocking. I got the date wrong. April 6th, 2015.
And you know what I want to say too, because a lot of times I realize things get very misconstrued and miscommunication. So before anything get miscommunicated, I want to say any one of those people. If ever y'all need anything from me, just hit me up. It is all.
Oh
good.
Yeah, it's all love. It's all love.
A lot of times
love,
people be thinking
all
like
all love.
You know what I mean? People
no,
be
all
weird.
Love.
I'm starting to realize like you really got to
Soho trends.
Express shout
out
to
Soho.
Yeah,
like everybody
man.
Who's come along this ride
love,
with us,
man.
It's always love, and you are a piece of the puzzle that has gotten us to where we are sitting right now.
That's
so
100.
I just, before the because this is the last show,
the last show of the year. Thank
I just wanted
everybody.
To take the time
shout
and show the gratitude.
To Ivy too for coming
yeah, shout
last
out
part.
To Ivy Rivera for coming, sitting down with us, that's chopping right. it up, talking shit. Shout out to Martell, our first liquor sponsor.
Right.
You know what I mean? I just
shout out Brooklyn or Bus. Don't
shout
do that.
Out Brooklyn.
Don't be petty.
Oh no! Of course, always it's always a shout out to Brooklyn.
You gotta keep
plugging what I'm
that.
Saying? Like, just don't tag him on pictures
right,
with Bay.
Right.
I learned the lesson. I got it. But no, shout out to Brooklyn the Bus. This is, you know, this is everything that makes the machine run. I just want to say thank you to everybody who's in this room, and just saying thank
Word.
You to everybody
bless
who listens.
Up,
like
up.
2019 is where we at, but 2020 is it's about to be real
be
lit.
Shit.
It's about to be as lit as this Brooklyn or Bus candle.
And right? I'm gonna start watching porn.
And on that note, make sure that you check us out. Check for us in 2020.
Now, before we go, real fast, what's your New Year's resolution? One good time.
To bring Bar Talk Radio to the top.
Can do. What's your New Year's resolution?
More many ladies.
And my New Year's resolutions is for you motherfuckers to leave me alone.
Lies. Unless you're at Brooklyn or
blessedapp.com.
Bar Talk Radio. We'll see y'all in 2020. Happy
Shout
New Year.
Shout out DJ Can
Do. NYC.
Shout out to the photographer. Holla.